Greetings, this is Brad from the Cheese Shop. This is the next video in the character creation series in GURPS. So in this video, I'm going to talk about advantages. So how the advantages work in GURPS, it's still a point buy system. So everything that you're going to purchase for your character as far as an advantage is going to be a positive for your character. So all of these are actually going to cost points, anywhere from 1 point to, you know, it just depends on the actual advantages. You know, some of them go 100 points or more. So there are three major advantages. The first one is the mental advantage. The other one is a physical advantage. And third one is social advantage. Did that so you could actually look inside the book. It actually shows you those three icons next to the advantage itself. So if we give you an example of a mental advantage of intuition, if you look that up, it's all alphabetical. You get to intuition, tells you how much it's worth in point value, and then next to it, it has a picture of a person's head. So you know that that's a mental advantage. Now, if you go into a physical advantage, an example of that would be something like acute senses. The reason why that would be a physical advantage is because it does take up some physicality within your body. So any kind of advantage that requires some sort of physical usage is going to be a physical advantage. The other one is a social advantage. An example of a social advantage would be something like contacts. And of course, if you think about contacts, this would be someone that, let's say you're a spy and your contact is someone within your spy organization, and they appear at a certain amount of time. Their frequency of appearance is set. How large the organization is, or maybe it's one person or multiple people. So everything there is going to give you a specific point value. And out of all of those point values, it makes up how many advantages you can have. So now we know the advantages broke up into three specific categories, the mental, physical, and social. And out of those three categories, there's actually another way to describe the advantages, and they're also into three different categories as well. Each of those advantages can be categorized as exotic, supernatural, or mundane. The exotic type advantage is denoted with an alien head. You'll see the little picture of that next to the advantage. The supernatural is denoted with a lightning bolt, and you'll also see that next to it. Mundane, there is no actual icon or anything like that. So any advantage that did not have the alien head or the lightning bolt is considered mundane. So to kind of give you an example of what these three types of categories are, is we'll look at exotic first. So an exotic advantage would be something like regeneration. So it's I've always looked at it as like it's physically plausible. Yeah, hardly. Not going to happen in our evolutionary stage, but it is possible for someone actually to heal faster than other people do. And in this case, this particular advantage, they heal at a much greater rate. Something else, an example would be of supernatural, would be magery. Now, magery is the ability to use magic. So you see how we've kind of jumped a little bit to a little bit different than just some sort of exotic advantage. And obviously, it's definitely different than mundane, which is, to give you an idea of a mundane advantage, would be something like I'm single-minded. So I can focus on something very, very well, and that's totally plausible for someone like me. So if I say I focus on GURPS, if I had to study about GURPS, or I had to give a lecture or write a book or write a paper or do something like that, because I can focus on that specifically, and I have that single-minded advantage, I would actually get an extra points to roll to do a specific task. So those with advantages, it's important to know what type of advantages you're allowed to have. And again, this is with the GM setting the limits and the expectations of what he or she wants in the adventure or the campaign whenever you create your character. So like I've said before in all the other videos, and I'm gonna say in the future videos, is you must talk to your GM about what you can and cannot have as far as advantages go. To give you an example of this, I had a I was running a pulp adventure, and I didn't allow any type of exotic or supernatural advantages in the game because I wanted it to be realistic, set 1920s. I wanted it to be gritty. So I said, hey, you know, go through your advantage list to all the players. And if you see something exotic or supernatural, you know you're not allowed to actually have it. Now, I put these things in place for the game balance as the GM, but also if a player comes to me and says, hey, I really want to take this particular exotic advantage, then if it can help the story and it can actually, I could actually work with that player, then I'll seriously consider letting them have the actual advantage. But we'll work it out together, and that's the whole point of, you know, it's part of character creation, is making sure that you're communicating with the GM and, you know, sometimes other players if that's what you like to do. So just remember that the GM may set limits on the different types of advantages you can have. But of course, if you're playing a superhero fantasy campaign, you know, set in a solar system away or in some just far off land, then there could be, you can take every disadvantage or every advantage. It doesn't matter. But just remember that to understand what the GM has set forth and the expectations and what limits you can have. Now, unlike disadvantage, I know I touched on this before, but I'll talk about it more in the next video, how disadvantages have limits. The GM will set limits. There are no limits to how many advantages you can have. I've seen people take, you know, acute senses and combat reflexes and just a slew of advantages, you know, 10, 15 different advantages, not spending a whole lot of points, but just taking, you know, a few points here or there and to really kind of round out their character in something other than just the skills. Because when you get to skills, you'll start to see how at this point your character is really coming together. And some people don't necessarily like doing that with just skills. They like to do it with advantages. So that was pretty much it for the advantages. I'm not going to read through all of them, just to let you know. I mean, obviously, they're all in alphabetical order, so they're very easy to find. If you're just making characters just for fun, which is cool, and I recommend that everybody do that because it gets you into a habit of, you know, maybe making characters at how it's easiest for you. You know, make a character that's kind of gritty, 1920s pulp, and then make a character kind of the same way, but maybe is in a different genre. You know, some sort of a space character or, you know, a fantasy character. You can do so many different things in GURPS. So just make sure that you just go through all the advantages, at least read through all of them, even if there's one that you're never going to use. Just read through so at least you know that it's there. And as always, make sure you talk to your GM. So the next video is going to be about disadvantages, and I look forward to making that. And to everybody out there, if you haven't been to my blog, it's thecheeseshop.org, and you can also learn more about GURPS at the link below for Steve Jackson Games. All right, bye.